5 months ago, Samsung announced the Galaxy S9 and S9 Plus at Mobile World Congress this year. How does it go for the S9 Duos now? Let's find out on this video. In terms of design, Samsung borrowed last year's Galaxy S8 and tweeted some of the enhancements, like the fingerprint scanner placement, or the stereo speakers, or maybe the iris slash face unlock combo scanner, and maybe Bixby button. Okay, let's not go there. I do like the software on this phone, especially the Plus variant, packed 6 GB of RAM rather than 4 GB on the non-Plus. It runs really smooth even with custom themes on it. Like any Android phones, it do get lag and stutter from time to time, but the animations does feel fast and doesn't make me want to wait. Swipe down on the fingerprint scanner to launch the notification shade is very convenient and useful most of the time. Taking selfies with the heart rate scanner feel kinda clumsy in the end, so I'd rather take photo with a hand gesture on the group photos, and that works. In terms of camera, it's still one of the phone that I can't live without it. From image processing to low light, the phone was very impressed. It can burst shot on both sides, and I'm also glad that videos produce really smooth no matter how I look at it. Here comes the bad part. While 4K 60 frames per second records up to 5 minutes, which is understandable, it has limited recording of 10 minutes in UHD or 1080p 60 frames per second, which still doesn't make sense since most brands doesn't have their restrictions. 960 frames per second slow motion video is fun, but only works well with bright lighting. Same thing goes to the telephoto lens on the S9 Plus, which has more opening than the main shooter but still useful in close-up situations. As of AR emoji, I have no comment about this. Another thing that I'm not really impressed is battery life. Even with 3500mAh battery pack, it only lasts me as around 3 to 3.5 hours of screen on time with around 30% of the battery juice left. That pacing is set to Full HD Plus with power saving mode on, by the way. For me, it's still not that great, especially I use phones like OnePlus 5T or the LG G17Q that lasts a lot longer than it should. Smaller details like wireless and wired fast charging is nice to have. For audio standpoint, the stereo speakers are great and Dolby Atmos enhancement produced are also in my ears, especially when it has a headphone jack, a rarity in modern phones these days. To sum it up, the Galaxy S9 / S9 Plus is a great smartphone, especially if you pick up a larger internal storage, which lacks on last year's Samsung 8 series. But even if you don't, there's microSD slot to back it up. If you're still thinking, is it still worth buying, I would say yes. But in the fast-paced smartphone world, new phone will come out every half a year, which is evident on the upcoming Galaxy Note 9 announced on August 9 and released in a few weeks' time. If you don't really bother on the S Pen functionality, you can get the S9 / S9 Plus in your neighborhood stores for cheaper since the price dropped rather quickly. If you have the S9 / S9 Plus right now, it's best to wait for new smartphones this quarter to drop by the end of the year, or just wait for next year to pack the latest technology, which someday you might be interested with. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, subscribe to my channel Mr. GWS and follow on my socials. As always, I will see you on the next video.